Hi, I'm Kat Wilson-Tucker of Next Step Quilt Designs. Today I'm going to show you how I made some of the hexagons in the bedscarf pattern 60, which is the quilt hanging behind me. I love using stripes in hexagons, but I was always afraid to. As it turns out, it is super, super easy to make. This is the first hexagon design that I'm going to demonstrate later using a different stripe fabric. It has 4 60-degree triangles and 1 diamond. As you can see, the stripes form the letter P. When you cut out this design, you will be cutting pieces for the next design at the same time. This hexagon also has 2 triangles and 2 diamonds that are opposite each other. The last hexagon looks like an asterisk. The 6 triangles are cut on the crosswise grain instead of the lengthwise grain. Play around with triangles, diamonds, and half hexagons to create new designs, or cut a whole hexagon. I am using this asymmetrical stripe fabric for demonstration. The tool for cutting diamonds and triangles is Creative Grid's 60-degree equilateral triangle. To calculate the length of the fabric required for the hexagon, measure the baseline of the triangle on the ruler, then multiply that number by 7. So for an 8-inch finished hexagon, I measured the 4.5-inch line on the ruler, and that came to just a little bit over 5.5 inches. So I rounded that up to 5 3/4, multiplied that by 7, and that came to 40 1/4 inches. Then I rounded that number up and cut the fabric at 41 inches. For this hexagon, I've decided that I want the purple to stand out a little bit more. So I've placed the 1/4-inch line between the light purple and the brown. I've moved my ruler up to finish my cut. I lined the edge of the ruler up along the piece of the fabric where I cut. Put the 1/4-inch line again between the purple and the brown stripe, and now I'm finished the cut. For the 8-inch finished hexagon, I need to cut a 4.5-inch strip. So I've lined up the 4.5-inch mark on the base of the fabric, and now I'm going to cut the strip. Okay, out of this 4.5-inch strip, I'll be cutting 2 hexagons, each with 4 triangles and 2 diamonds. I've placed the 4.5-inch mark on the ruler along the baseline of the strip. Now I'll cut. Now what you do is you turn the ruler around and line the 4.5-inch line at the top and the edge of the ruler along where you just cut. Okay. Now we'll do this 3 more times. I've now cut the 4 triangles for each hexagon, a total of 8. And now I'm going to cut the diamond. So what we do is place the intersection point of the 4.5-inch line and the seam line right on the very top corner, and place the 4.5-inch line across the top of the strip, and then cut. These are the pieces for the 2 letter P hexagons. The triangles and diamond aligned at the bottom are for 1 hexagon. The ones at the top are for the other. Before sewing, lay out the pieces. Don't worry about the gap, it should be there. Okay, I've laid out the hexagon. We'll sew 1 half together and then the other half and then the 2 halves together. So first thing you do is take the 2 pieces. You see how all the stripes match up? Put a pin between the 2 lines here, pin it on the other side, and poke it through. You only need to do three or four of these for this size of triangle. Your piece is ready to sew together, so start at the edge there, and you want to sew your quarter inch. I hold the pin one at one end, and then when you get to the pin, you crank over, pull the pin out, again hold the pin, hand crank over the pin, pull the pin out, hold the pin, okay, now I've sewn the two triangles together and I'm going to press the seams open. So what you do, you press once and then open this, and then when you flip it over in this way, you only have to pull back one seam because you've already pressed the other one to the side. Hold it there. Flip it over and press again. And there you have two of the triangles together. The two halves are finished. Now we're going to sew the two halves together. We start by pinning in the center. And then you want to put a pin on each side to stabilize the center. Then you want to match your stripes. And again, pin in the intersection between the two colors. We'll begin by sewing where the stripes don't match so that the bias is on the bottom. We're pressing open the final seam of the letter P hexagon. First, press it to one way like you would a normal seam. And then flip it over. And it's easier to run your fingers then along the seam. Give it a final steam. Flip it over and press again. And there we have it. The letter P hexagon is finished and we're ready to start another one. This is the hexagon that we just worked through. And here is the other letter P hexagon that was cut at the same time. Thank you for joining me for this edition of Next Step Quilt Designs. I hope you enjoyed learning how to make the letter P hexagon. It's so much easier than you probably thought. Check out my channel for more hexagon designs and other tutorials.